marriage life. Now we have a lot of advice and direction that the rabbis give us. We are 12 lines from the bottom of page 62b. אמר רבי תנחום אמר רב חנינא לאי, כל אדם שאין לו אישה שרוי בלא שמחה ולא ברכה ולא טובה. A person that live without a wife is no happiness, no blessing, no goodness. בלא שמחה דכתיב ושמחת אתה וביתך. The Torah said in Deuteronomy chapter 14, you shall be happy, you and your household. If you remember, we studied both in Tractate Yomah when we talk about the high priests, and we call it Ishto Beito. It's also Gemara in Sota, page 44. That's a euphemism for the house, wife, is the same meaning. Belo bracha dichtiv leaniach bracha el betecha. Ezekiel chapter 44, they said it's a blessing in your home. Belo tova dichtiv lo tov veyot adam levado. The Torah said in Genesis chapter 2, it's not good for a man to be alone, and therefore God created Ezer ken negdo. B'ma'arav ha'amri, in Eretz Israel they said, belo Torah, belo choma, meaning without protection. Choma is like a shield, like a wall. Belo Torah dichtiv, this is a quotation from the book of Job, chapter 6. Ha'im en ezrati bi ותושיה נדחה ממני. תושיה, it's the euphemism for the word of Torah. The idea is that she's involved with a need in a house. If Rashi said, if a person need to do all the day by day mundane things in a house, he will not be able to occupy himself with the study of Torah. בלא חומה דכתיב נקבה תסובב גבר. Jeremiah said in 31, it will be a time that nekeva, meaning the woman, will be around the man. It means that according to the Maharsha, she is basically the protection against Yetzer Hara, against evil inclination. She is basically giving a shield so he will not reach temptation. So the Kitzuv Shulchan Aruch, Rabbi Gansfried in Kuf Mem Zayin, he said that that's the one of the reasons why you see the bride circling around the groom seven times. It's the idea that she's creating some type of spiritual protection against all the evil inclination that and temptation she have. Rava Bar-Ula Amar, Belo Shalom, is no peace. Dechtiv, they said in the book of Job, chapter 5, Yadata ki shalom ha'olecha u'pagadta navecha velo techta. Meaning, again, this is holecha, it's the ohel, it's the euphemism for isha, which means when you leave, you have protection against sin. Amar Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi, kol yodea b'ishto shirat shamayim v'eno pogda, nikra chote. If a person knows his wife has a fear of God, and he is avoiding relation from her, here we not talk about a person who is physically ill, we talk about a person who is basically expecting her to demand, etc. שנאמר וידעת כי שלום הולך. So it means, some interpretations say that she is modest and therefore she not express it, and therefore he may misconstrue her. Or the other option is that it means that he tried to avoid the relation with her. So that's the text called Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi calling a sinner. ואמר רבי יהושע בן לוי חייב אדם לבכות אשתו בשעה שהוא יוצא לדרך. He said that before a person departed, he should have a relation with his wife. Rashi tells us, משום שמתהווה לו באותה שעה יותר, שנאמר וידעת כי שלום מהו לך. So, המהכה נפקה, מעטה נפקה. ולשך תשוקתך, מלמד שהאישה משוות לבעלה בשביל שהוא יוצא לדרך. So, meaning that that's the type of interaction, and he needs to, in a way, not to ignore it, to cooperate. אמר רב יוסף, לא נצרכה אלא סמוך לביסתה. אמר רב העונה. So Rashi said that that's תשמיש ממש, when it's come to לצאת לדרך, they allow it. תוספות and תוספות ישנים said that it's not necessarily a relation, it can be just a word, you call it pius, which means appeasing, be nice in the interaction, even and she's in a state of nida, he has the obligation to interact with her with a proper manner and respect. V'hanemile l'dvar reshut, aval l'dvar mitzvah mitredei. Sometimes when he's so occupied with mitzvah, and again, the Ramban has a big issue with that, if that's biblical or rabbinic, but since he is occupied with mitzvah, that's the exception. Tanu Rabbanan ohev et ishto kegufo v'mechaber yoter megufo. The rabbi said, if someone loves his wife as himself, and v'hamechabda, so Rashi said, yoter megufo, dezilutah de'iteta kashya midegavra. He says that don't think, this is talk to the man, right, Gilbert? They said to men that the perception of the women is very different than men. We, meaning the men, sometimes thinking why we need constantly to buy stuff, right? Buy jewelry, buy clothing, buy things, right? Before holidays, etc. But women see it in different way, not like a man, and therefore you have to do that, and you have to do it with a great respect. והמדריך בניו ובנותיו בדרך ישרה, one who lead his children in the proper path, והמסיען סמוך לפרקם, which means make sure that you marry them on the proper time, which means before they reach, they too old in age, but they do it in a time that they should get married. עליו הכתוב אומר, ולדעת כשלום עליך, this is a recipe for peace. האוהב את שכנם והמקרב את קרוביו, והנושא את בת אחותו. So again, that's an advice to marry the בת אחותו. The truth is that 11th century it was a great rabbi by the name of Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid. I gave several lectures, if you remember in the past, about him and his tzava'ah and his famous will. One of the takanot, one of the decree of Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid is not marrying בת אחותו, the daughter of his sister. But the great Rav Vozner, Vozner gave me a beautiful skama in my book. He said that it's quite contrary to the way that people think, that married to daughter of the sister, a woman he knows and is fond of as a family relative and not only as a wife, he said that he promised a good life. But again, now generation, you don't see it. If someone lend a poor person money at a time of great press, great need, עליו הכתוב אומר, Isaiah 58, אז תקרא והשם יענה תשווע ויאמר הנני. So the idea is that it's a measure for measure. You're helping, השם will help you. אישה, סימן אישה וקרקע עזר זאת, שתי הברכות הגרי פחתי. So that's basically the acronym. The Zohar said that in order for a person to call Adam, it's the combination of the Adam before he departed, before Hashem took a rib and make his wife, so therefore it's all together. Most of this ma'amarim goes by Rabbi Elazar. The first one, Amar Rabbi Elazar, kol adam shein lo isha eino Adam. A person that lives without wife is not considering Adam, meaning a fullest person. Shenemar, they said in Genesis chapter 5, Zachar unkeva Abraham. Vayikra et shmam Adam, meaning, as we said, the Zohar in the book of Vayikra, chapter 7, said that there is a combination of Adam, like Adama, Adame le'elyon, meaning the image of the Almighty, which is makes him complete by being together. V'amar Rabbi Elazar, kol she'adam she'en lo karka eino Adam, she'nemar min ha'shamayim she'amar min ha'shem, v'aretz natan lebnei Adam. Meaning that the persons have some place to... There's a few interpretations. Tosfot said that he's not a homeless that goes and sleep in a park, right? They have some place to be. But there are other interpretations as well. Amar Rabbi Elazar, the third one, Ma'ad Yichtiv, Eselo Ezer Kenegdo. What does that mean, Genesis 2? I shall make him a corresponding help. On one hand you said help, on the other hand, Negdo, meaning the opposite. Zacha ozarto, if he's merited, she is his help. Lo zacha kenegdo, she can be his worst enemy. So it's like a famous saying, they said the word ish, ish and isha, you take out aleph, aleph yud shin is ish, right? Isha is aleph shin hey. You take the Hashem from their marriage life, which is a yud, right? and therefore it left ash, ash meaning fire. Right? ויקה דאמרי, רבי לזר רמי, כתיב כנגדו, they said that it's like an opposite than him, וקרינן כנגדו. So there is a book called Dudae Reuven, written by a great rabbi Reuven Katz. He is a relative of my wife's family. Anyway, so he said, what does that mean, Ezer Kenegdo? Ezer meaning help, Kenegdo to oppose him. He says that conflicted messages. So he said, the Hashem created a person for his leto'alto, for his sake, for his good. But he said the goal of a wife is to have a complete life, meaning to be a help, to educate the children, to be part of, etc., of a person's life. But sometimes it can happen by giving a compliment. Sometimes when he's slapped on the face, not necessarily physically, it's in order to help a person. Zacha kenegdo, lo zacha menagadeto, meaning if he goes in the right path, she is with him. But if he is about to do wrong things, she is there to protect him, not to fall. The problem is that many men do not see it in that perception, right? So there is a book written by Rabbi Shlomo Ganzfried, you know, the great rabbi that wrote the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. He wrote a book called Apiyon LiShlomo. He said that sometimes the opposite is very positive things. It's like you have pot and you have the cover of the pot. You have two opposites. He said that normal children, if they grow in a house that it's a total the same parents, usually, he said, the children will not come out in a 100% normal. When they are opposite, not to the extreme, but the different avenues in thinking, usually the children grow up properly because they see the different perception of life. Ashkere Rabbi Yossi le'Eliyahu. So the Eliyahu Navi. Amar le'kti ve'eseh lo ezer. B'mei isha azorto la'adam. How the wife can be a great help for a person. Amar lo, Adam. Levi chitin, chitin koses, pishtan, pishtan lovesh. Lo nimtzet, meira enav o'mito l'raglav. So this is for sure as a euphemism. The idea is that Meiri explained that because she's really, what's it called in Yiddish, balabuste? How do you say it in English? I don't know. But anyway, she is taking care of all the things. She's basically enlightened a person's life, make him do what he have to do in a peace in his mind. My late grandmother, the great Rebbetzin, Brandwein, she used to say, how do you know that the wife is good? She says, if the husband is not thinking all day what she's doing now, who knows what she's doing now? If he's not have that in his mind, it means that she's a good wife. Anyway, the Marsha says, we learn in the Parsha, if you remember the Parsha Vayetze, the Torah said, ונתן לי לחם לאכול ובגד ללבוש. Yaakov Avinu asked, he's about to go and marry the wife, right? And that's what happened. So he prayed, לחם לאכול בגד ללבוש, which means a proper maid. ואמר רבי אלעזר, מה דכתיב? זאת הפעם, עצם העצמי ובשר מבשרי. What does that mean when it's called that wife, she's part of me? מלמד שבא אדם על כל במה וחייב לו נתקרר לתועל שבא לחווה. So the Mephoshim said that that doesn't mean physical relation with animals, but the Mephoshim said that that's a muskalot, which the Maharal explained that he analyzed. Adam have the godly image, godly capability to analyze, and he analyzed that that it can be a total satisfaction only in the intercourse and interaction of woman, which is his soulmate and nothing else, but it's not a physical was only Adam and Eve. ואמר רבי אלעזר, מה ידכתיב ונברכו בך כל משפחות האדמה? What does that mean when God bless our forefather in Genesis 12, that all the nations will be blessed because of you? That's my neighbor always said to us. So they said, אמר לקדוש ברוך הוא לאברהם, שתי ברכות טובות יש להבריך בך. You're going to have a two great blessing in the future. So Rashi tells us that that's applied to the planting. He said, כמו מבריך את הגפן, So, as you know, the part of the process, you're planting a seed, but you're not just planting the seed. You do it in such a way that you make it fruitful. You make it a coming out as a excellent, a very good fruit, a good produce. So it means that it's a prophecy. Ruta Moavia and Naama Ha'amonit. Both of them are converts, sincere converts. And as a result for that, they come out a blessing to all of our nations. So you see from here the concept of future come out of good. One of the leader of the Musar movement, remember we studied Musar movement, the Lithuanian movement that dealt with the importance of cleanness, the importance of proper life. So it was named, the rabbi's name was Rabbeinu Yerucham. We study, if you remember, in the past. So he said, imagine if, for example, a person get a blessing with money. You have a lot of money. So what do you do with the money? Buying drugs, buying alcohol, buying things that damage him. Do you know people like that? They have a lot of money, and a lot of that money go to Hollywood, you see it a lot, right? And people use that money in the wrong way. So instead of taking that and use it to serve Hashem and to fulfill what he's supposed to do, he created the self-destruction. That's what they meant when they used the term Zacha Zoche. Zacha, he said, is like Lashon Zach. Like you get a great gift, meaning you get a wife so you can be at peace, you can study peacefully, you can occupy yourself. All the desire have the right place, but I said sometimes a person gets from Hashem a lot of gifts, and he, instead of appreciate that, he take that gift and use it against himself. Anyway, so he said here, kol mishpechot ha'adama, afilu mishpechot hadarot ba'adama en itbarchot ela bishvil Yisrael. So you see here all those future inhabitants blessed because of us. And you see it a lot. From Ruth, we have the King David. From Naama, it was the King Rehavam. That out of that, the righteous people like Chizkiyah or Yeshayahu came out. Afilu sfinot abot migali laspami anan b'chod b'shvil Yisrael. So the Tosfot said, because they are mostly over in the sea. ואמר בלעזר, עבדים כל בעלי המוניות שעמדו על הקרקע. So Rashi tells us that at the end of the days, the Messianic era, people will occupy themselves with agriculture, etc. שנאמר, they said in Ezekiel chapter 27, וירדו מהם יותם כל תופסי משות, מלאכים כל חובלי הים, אל הארץ יעמודו. So again, the Aruch Loner said that the proper גרסה is בעלי אוניות. It's involved with the great risks, the leaving the family, etc. ואמר בלעזר, אין לך אומנות פחותה מן הקרקע, שנאמר, וירדו. So, which means, Rashi said that they reach poverty. Maharal explained that it's the lowest for certain purposes, like the Maharsha, he said that in order for people to be satisfied with their lot, רבי לזר חזי על היערה דשדי ביקרה בלפוטיה. אמר לי, יתשדי לאורכך, הפוכי בייס כתב מנח. So I explained my book on Rashi. Rashi said, כלומר אפילו תחזור ותחרשנו לא יועיל כלום לפי עסקה. So the question is, what does that mean when you are speaking about occupy yourself with the with the agriculture work. So Rashi said that even you planted and poling around the field, it's still not sufficient, because doing merchant business always better than just working in the field. Meaning, when you're involved in a business world, even sometimes you lose, but basically by doing selling and buying, eventually you make a nice profit. Versus if you are structural or walking in a field, it's a different story. But for sure, there are other avenues to understand this. Rab ala levnei shablei, chazinu de kanaifan. So, similar story, Rab entered between the sheaves in the field and saw them waving in the wind, which is a beautiful scene. So that's the Gemara in Bava Batra at the beginning. They said that when you see them moving, it's a beautiful. So they said, Amar lehu, inayaft itn yafune, apuchik beiskach, tav minach. So he said, you know what? He said to them, if you want to wave, go ahead and wave. But conducting business is better than farming with you. As we said. Amarava me'azuzei be'iska, kol yoma bisra v'charmra. So he said, if a person have 100 zuzei, in those days it was dinar, in the investment, so he can eat every day meat and wine, meaning he makes a very nice profit margin. Me'azuzei be'ara, if he put 100 dinars in the field, milcha v'chafura, he needs to eat, it's like meat, need to eat salt and vegetables. So it's like in Arabic, they said, yom asal, yom basal. One day you eat onion, another day you eat honey. Anyway, velod ela meganya le'ara. It caused him to sleep on the ground, which means either Meiri said that he is homeless, or he is like Boaz. He needs to watch over the field all the time, so he needs to sleep over there to watch to make sure that the thieves will not come in and steal. Umerami le tigre, and it's always fights over boundaries, over others. So now it's likutei etzot. Now it's a collection of advice that they give. Amar Rav Azra v'lo tazbin. He said, it's better that for you to sow your own produce, like many Sephardim, right, Gilbert? They planted outside of the home, the food. And v'lo tazbin, and don't go to buy it in the market. Just plant your own seed. Even the expense, it's sometimes the same. What you do it by yourself, they have a better blessings. The Gemara in Bava Metzia 42 says that something that measured is not a blessing. Something that it's in you, it is. Zabin velo tezur. Hanim mile bistarke. That's applied to selling rugs. Ask the Persians, right? Aval glima lo mitram yalei. So, the way life is, that's based in Maran Shabbat 1:13. Sometimes person have ups and downs in life. There is a setback. There is a great heights. That's the way life is. So they said sometimes a person needs to give up some conveniences in life, need to cut the fat or cut budget to do things like that, in order for the future to live better. He needs to learn to do it. But a person should set up boundaries. So they give an advice, for example, clothing. That this is something that it's individual, it's something that you like, and don't do that. One time, I know a guy, he lives in one of those religious cities in Israel. So they reach a point, they need money, and it was a discussion between him and his wife. So she said to him, look, your mother gave me a beautiful ring and diamond. So let's sell it. We sell it and we make it, at least for some times, and then hopefully we'll do other things. So we take that money, we open a small business, we'll do something. So then it was a discussion because they don't want his mother to see it because she gets angry, etc., etc. So they together decided to buy a fake one that looked the same as this one. You know what I'm talking about? Right? And therefore they can use it, right? So he called and turns. Listen to this. He went to the jewelry, and the jewelry guy told him that his mother already did it many years ago.
The one he had was fake.
So he called and he said, what should I do now? If I tell that to my wife, she will be, how do you say it in English, pissed off, yeah. Right? Anyway, we tried to help him. Anyway, Tom Velote Shapetz. So if you see a hole in your house, so what happened with people, what do? You call the insurance company, right? They come in, they said to you, you have a deductible, and the rest we're going to give you. We're not going to give you over these materials, but we give you over the damage that those materials cause you, right? So all of a sudden you have junk off money coming in. You figure out, guess what? I'm going to change the whole kitchen, right? Knocked out and changed. So the Gemara said, Shapots velo tivne, shekol haoseg bebinyan mitmasken. Guess what's going to happen? They said, don't, you're going to reach, when you do these type of things, when constructions, Alois will tell you. That you think a number, and always add another 20% to that numbers. So far, I never met, you can ask Eli too. You cannot find any contractor that gives you a number and that's going to be the final price. I never met that guy. Only if he overextended, he give you in advance 20% more, and then it may give you back something or you finish in the same balance. It never happened. You start the project, even you do it by yourself, and it's the way that you go to Home Depot and return the same manner. So they give you advice. They said, look, if you're not really in desperate need, you want to sell the property, etc., etc., don't do that. Just fix it locally and leave it alone, right? Because if you start there, you never end it, right? Kfotz uzvin ara. If you have a chance, you don't want the money. If you reach, suddenly some income come in. You make money in the stock, whatever it is. You get some money from some sources. In order for the money not to, how do you say, evaporate, so the Meiri said, go right away and buy real estate or buy something substantial. Because otherwise, before you know it, the money is out, is not there.
This is Ellie's favorite Gemara.
I have to ask you. Metun nesiv iteta. Don't rush when you get to get married. Do it with thought. Don't be so impetuous. So the Meiri, based on Rashi, said, guess why? He said, because sometimes you're thinking that that's the best mate, and when it's closed doors inside your home, there are a lot of issues, right? Personality, etc. So they advise you, and they said, Nechit darga siv iteta. I don't know how our American audience is going to like it, but I do not compose it, as you know. But the idea is, do not take a wife that she's above you. Meaning, she don't take someone that she looks down at you. You have to get someone that being in a way, look up at you, and not be arrogant over you. Sak darga b'char shush vina. When it's come to a friend, if you need to choose a friend, get someone who's above you. So someone you can take a counsel, share secrets, etc. So you have to be careful with these things. Anyway. Amar Rabbi Lazar bar Ravina. אין פורענות באה לעולם אלא בשביל ישראל, שנאמר in the book of צפניה, chapter 3, ויקראתי גויים נשם ופינותם, וחרבתי חוצותם. וכתיב אמרתי, אך תראי אותי, תקחי מוסר. So Rebbe Chanon Wasserman explains, may you rest in peace, he says, when it's come to פיראון, so פורענות is like פיראון. He said that the calamity, before, because of a reason. So it's like, give us an opportunity to open our hearts and to do teshuva. If we look and realize the world phenomena and the world incidences, it doesn't happen overnight that everything will change. It happens in a gradual way. So hopefully we'll open our eyes and do teshuva. Now we go back to the subject of marriage. since earlier we talk about good wife, now they're talking about someone with issues, like Miri explained, someone who's agitated, etc., etc. Rav Hava Miptar Mirabi Chia. So these both two rabbis have, they call the term Nashim Ra'ot, meaning, I don't know if I'm using the right term, but it's basically bad wives. So Amar Lei, Rachamana Litzlach Mimidi Dekashe Bemotach. He says, you'll have a world to come because the Almighty have mercy on you and give you, how do you say it, hell in this life. So after life you have peace. So Rav was shocked. He says, "Umia ika midi de kashe mimota? You're going to tell me that that's something worse than death?" Nafak dak ve'ashkach. He found a line that said in Ecclesiastic chapter 7, King Solomon said, "Umotze ani mar mimavet et ha'isha." He said that Maharsha explained that sometimes a man feels so bad in his marriage life that he said, I'll better die than to live with her. It's a lot of stories about it. The key is that it's a constant fight, it's a constant issues, and a person feels sometimes meaningless in his life. It's a famous story about Rabbi Kanievsky's father, the stipler. So as a fellow that was a way advanced in age, couldn't find his mate, couldn't find his shidduch. One time, eventually, he found someone and he wanted her, and they said a wonderful thing about her, that she's full of kindness, etc., etc. So he went to the stipler and he asked for bracha, he asked for blessings. So he described how she does so much chesed, so much goodness, she helped this organization, that organization, etc., etc. So the stipler looked at him and says, I don't understand, so why you want to marry her? So he said, because she does all of that. He says, but you didn't speak one word about how she behaved inside the house. You're talking only how she's great and good and kindness and doing all the wonderful things for so many people outside. But what happened inside the house? So this fellow was like shocked. The rabbi refused to give him bracha. So he went to his date with that girl and he told her the story, what the stipler said. And guess what happened? She admitted. And she said, inside my parents' house, I'm very strict. And they said that I'm very unpleasant, and it's very hard to communicate with me. But yes, he's right. Outside, I'm doing a lot of goods to other people. And as a result, they break up. They broke up. So that's the way it is. It's a famous story about the Mashgiach, Meir Chodesh. It was a famous Mashgiach. So one of the Bachurim, young man, came and said, look, all these shadchanim, all these matchmaker lying, they tell you all kind of stories, and it's all acting up, and how do I know that, what should I really search when I'm looking for shidduch? So he said, the centerpiece of the house is called akshanut. Akshanut meaning stubbornness. If you have a way to find out, that's the secret. It's like, you know, the famous comedian Jackie Mason. Did you ever see that scene with the Jewish husband? Yes? No? Yes? So he described a Jewish husband. I meant, it's not everyone, but he described a guy goes to a shop. They see it in a store. He says, so they offer him something. He said, do you like it? He says, what do you think? He looked at her. You like it? Yeah, I like it. No, oh, no, I don't like it. Yes, maybe. Yes, no. How about you like it? I like it. No, you don't. No, I don't like it. That's a description to describe a Jewish husband. So sometimes it's a good advice for some people. Anyway, Rab Hava Kametzara LeDevitu. This is a painful story. Rav, which was a great Talmid Chacham, great sage, he have a very hard life, marriage life. His wife caused him a lot of sorrows. Ki amar le'avid litlofchei avdalei chimtzei. Guess what happened? Every time he asked her to do something, she did something else. For example, he said, prepare me a lentil. She will prepare for him peas. Chimtzei avdalei litlofchei. He wants peas, she prepared for him lentils. So, kigadal chiyabrei, when the son grew up and he saw what's going on between the parents, apichlei. So what did he do? He twisted, meaning he knew that the father wants something for lunch. Let's say he wants peas. So he didn't say to his mother, dad wants peas. He told the mother the other way around, because he knew that she's going to do it in the reverse order. He came to eat lunch, and all of a sudden he said to his son, I can't believe, look at your mother, she changed for good. So the son said, Amar lei, and now the kap chinan lei. After he ate, he says, I'm the one who caused it, that I twisted what you request for lunch. Amar lei, hanu de kam reim shei, benafik minach tam amelfanach. So, at lo ta'avidachi, shenemar limdul shunam davar sheker ha'aveh. So he told him, that's not what I'm expecting you, because you basically grew up to be an untruthful person. And that's not the proper way. The Ben Ish Chai said that it's all dependent on the dynamics. Sometimes there is some ways that you can exaggerate the truth in order to create peace. Anyway, Rabbi Chiya v'kamistar ledebitu, another rabbi has a hard life with his wife. She caused him a lot of sorrow. Ki ava mashkach midei, tzair le besodar yomaiten yala. However, when he would find something that she will appreciate, like a nice clothing, so he wrap it, the shawl, and bring it to her. So, it's like he wants to show a good faith, friendship, etc. Amar le Rav, ve'aka metzar le lemar. So Rav said to him, why are you doing that? She caused you so much agony and pain. Amar lo, yes, answer him, he said, Dayenu, it's enough for us that our wives, shemegadlot baneinu, that they raised our children, umatzilot otanu, and save us min achet, from sin. 53b, so the Ben Yoyada explain why they use the term sudre. So he says, in those days, the siman heker le talmid chacham, the way that you recognize in those days the uniform, the dress code for the Torah scholars, was a suda. So he said he wants to tell her that my success, like Rabbi Akiva and Rachel, my success, it's because of you. It's like famous instructions we have in those days from the Rosh Yeshiva. He said, you should always express your gratitude, but it should be sincere, not just a lip service. Makre la Rav Yudah le Rav Yitzchak Brei, umotze ani mar mimavet et haisha. Amar le kegon mai, amar so kegon imcha. So here's an example. Va matne le Rav Yudah le Rav Yitzchak Brei, an adam motze korach truach chen amishto rishona, shnemar im korcha baruch usmach meeshet meurecha. ואמר לכגון מן, כגון אמך. So he said, מתקיף תקיפה ואבורי מיברה במילה. So he said that, for example, in that sense, your mother, that he said that she was aggressive and forceful, but she was easily appeased. Anyway, so that's...
easily angered, easily appeased.
Hey, chedam eisha ra'ah. What is the circumstances when a woman is considered a bad wife? First example, Amar Abaye, Mekashel Etaka u'Mekashel Epuma, which means she make a very nice table and then she curse him, or she does all kind of things to cause him sorrow. Rabba Amar, Mekashel Etaka u'Mehadre Legaba. So she prepared a beautiful table, beautiful food, but then she stayed away from him. She turned her back to him. Mm-hmm. She's not sitting. You're going to eat by yourself. I'm not coming there. Right? Turn around and talk with the friends on a cell phone. Or the Benyo Yada said, even worse, she said to him, bring all your friends. And she made a gorgeous table and everything is set up beautifully. And then at the middle of the meal, she let him have it at the front of all of his friends. אמר רבי חייא בר חנינא, כיוון שנשא אדם אישה ונותיו מתפקקים, as we said, she saved the husband from sin, so the moment he married, he is in a way, his sins, his iniquities crumble. Because they said, שנאמר in the book of Proverbs, משלי 18, מצא אישה, מצא טוב ויפק רצון מהשם. So it's that match the word ויפק, פיקוק. במערבה, in ארץ ישראל, כי נסיב איש איתה אמר לי, אחי, מצא או מוצא? מצא, דכתיב, מצא אישה, מצא טוב, מוצא, דכתיב, מוצא אני מר ממוות את האישה. So it's always, you hear the Rabbonim speak at the Shev HaBrachos, always they talk about the difference between מצא and מוצא. When is a person in a sense of מצא, and when is the other way around, מוצא. It's a lot of מדרשים. אמר רבה, אישה רעה, מצווה לגרשה. It's a mitzvah to divorce a bad wife. דכתיב, because they said in Proverbs 22, גרש לץ ויצא מזון, מדון, וישבות דין וקלון. It's a big discussion, what is that mean? There is one school of thought that said that that's apply only when they have no children. There is another school of thought that it's all depend upon the what exactly the issues. There is a discussion among some rabbis that said that you see those example even of the great luminary rabbis like Rav Yehuda in Tractate Nida page 20 or like Rav Yossi Aglili in the Yerushalmi Ketubot 11 that they divorced their wives. But anyway, ואמר רבא, אישה רעה וכתובתה מרובה צרתה בצידה. So they give advice, in those days a man can marry more than once, so more than one wife. So they said, if you have a very bad wife, and the ketubah, the marriage agreement is very high, and you cannot overcome all the expenses, so guess what you should do? You should have a second wife. So what happened is, when she see that there is a competition, which means, as a result, there's a people said, in the well-edged, the way to trouble a woman is to her peer, with her peer, and not with her thorn. Anyway, אמר רבא קשאי שראה כיום סגריר. Again, using a euphemism, it said a bad wife is troublesome as a day of heavy rain. שנאמר, they said in Mishlei, in the Proverbs 27, דלף תורד ביום סגריר ואשת מדיינים נשתווה. ואמר רבא, בואו ראה כמה טובה אישה טובה וכמה רעה אישה רעה. Come and see how good is it when you have a good wife and how bad is it when you have a bad one. כמה טובה אישה טובה לכתיב, מצא אישה מצא טוב. You find a wife, you find good. אי בגבה משתה אקרא, כמה טובה אישה טובה, שהכתוב משבחה, you see, the pasuk said clearly that אי בתורה משתה אקרא, כמה טובה אישה טובה, שהתורה נמשלה בה. That even it uses as a Torah, which is the highest level. The other way around, כמה רעה אישה רעה, לכתיב, מוצא אני מר ממוות לאישה, as we said, that sometimes you're feeling like you better die, you feel like it's so much tension and problem and distress in a house. אי בגבה משתה יקרא כמה רעה אישה רעה שכתוב מגנה ובגינו משתה יקרא כמה רעה אישה רעה שגינו נמשבה. So again, I have a friend, his wife once said to him, you have a Gan Eden. And he looked at her and she said, because I'm definitely אישה רעה. But the truth of the matter, the rabbi tells us that it's many, many times depend upon the man's behavior. And sometimes he's the cause of all these problems, etc. You see it in Adam and Eve, that he blamed her over things that... Anyway, Jeremiah 11. הנני מביא רעה אשר לא יוכלו לצאת ממנה. רב נחמן אמר רב הרבוע הזו אישה רעה וכתובתה מרובה. Meaning, someone who wished to divorce, but he realized that the expenses are way too high. So he's staying in a marriage, in very unhappy marriage life, while he's struggled greatly. That's basically what Jeremiah said, I bring upon them evil that they cannot walk out of that. And that's basically the meaning, that the expenses overwhelm the person and make him being in a way in a jail. נתנני השם בידי לא אוכל קום. In the book of Lamentation, chapter 1, Jeremiah said that Hashem put me in a place that I cannot stand up. אמר רב חיסדא, אמר מרוק ובחי, זו אישה רעה וכתובתה מרובה. That in one hand, he cannot live with her. He feels miserable. On the other hand, he cannot divorce her, as we said, because of all the expenses involved. במערבה אמרו זה מי שמזונותיו תלויים בכספו, which means someone who's always depend upon the market. He can be one day very poor, another day rich, and he's not stable, so therefore he's always in that situation of the unknown. There's other interpretations as well. They said in a series of admonition in Deuteronomy 28, בניך ובנותיך נתונים לעם אחר, אמר רב חנן בר אבא, אמר רב, זו אשת האב, which means a stepmother. So it means that they, many times the relationship, either she feel this is not my children, or they feel this is not our mother, and you see all this tension. I don't know if you notice, sometimes we receive wedding invitations, and you see the list of the steps. There's, anyway. בגוי נבל אחיסם, אמר רב חנן ברב, אמר רב זו אישה רעה וכתובתה מרובה, as we said earlier. רבי אליעזר אומר, אלו המינים, וכן אומר אמר נבל בריבו אל אלוקים. במתניתן, the third explanation, תנא, אלו אנשי ברבריה ואנשי מרתנאי, שמהלכים ערומים בשוק. That's the places in North Africa. So it means that they go with very little clothes, ושאין לך משוקץ ומתואב לפני המקום יותר ממי שהולך ארום בשוק. It means that it's like basically like animals. The fourth explanation, רבי יוחנן אמר, רבי יוחנן אמר, אלו חברים. So either it's a Persian that not respect us, or that's the Rashi. Others, they said, like Tosfot and Aruch, they said that they are sorcerer. אמרו לרבי יוחנן, אתו חברי לבבל, שגן אפל. He just bowed down from sorrow. Then he said, אמרו לי מקבלי שוחדה, they accept bribe. Upon hearing that, not all was lost. Teritz yatim. So he strengthened himself and said, in the place once again. Gazru al shlosha. So they said that they issued decrees against the Jewish people with regard to three matters. So they mipnei shlosha. Gazru al habasar, mipnei hamatanot. So they said that they put the decree against eating meat. And they ban ritual slaughter due to the failure of the Jewish people to give the priests the gift of the foreleg, the jaw, and the maw. Then gazru al hamerchatzaot mipnei hatvila, because people in Babylon did not behave properly when it's come to that, using the ritual bath. The Gemara says in Brachot 22 that they felt that they don't need to duck themselves, and Rabbi Yochanan disagreed with them before the study. Kam mechatete ishchach vei, which means they opened the graves what wasn't necessary. Mipnei shesmechim biyom edam, which means that this is the day of the idol worshiper celebrated. And שנאמר, they said in the book of Shmuel, Samuel, chapter 12, והייתה יד השם בכם ובבדכם, אמר רבה, ושמול זו חטות אישך, ולמרמר, ואבון חיים מתים מתחטטים. So the idea is, due to the inquiry of the living, the dead are exam. So the idea is that to be careful, not to, basically we said it many times, we're not allowed to do that by any means. The only time you transfer graves, it's if it's a huge desecration of cemetery or people want to transfer towards Israel. אמר לרבא, רבא, לרבא מרמרי, כתיב, they said in Jeremiah 8, לא יאספו ולא יקברו לדומן על פני אדמה יהיו. הוא כתיב ונבחר מוות מחיים. אמר לי, נבחר מוות לרשעים שלא יכלו בעולם הזה ויכתבו ויפלו בגיהנום. כתיב, כתוב בספר בן סירא, בן סירא is one of the book of חיצוניים, that's the scribe that lived during this era of the second temple. Considered ספרים חיצוניים, it's a lot of morals and allegories, etc. So it's written, אישה טובה מתנה טובה. The person of a good wife is a great gift. בחק ירא אלוהים תינתן. Someone who fear God, a man of God, he deserved to have that. אישה רעה צרעת לבעלה. But if he is a bad wife, she's like a leprosy to her husband. מי תקנתי, יגרשנה ויתרפא מצרעתו. There's no choice but to divorce her and then he get out of the leprosy. אישה יפה אשרי בעלה מספר ימיו כפליים. So Rashi tells us, כלומר, שמח בחלקו ודומה לו כאילו ימיו כפליים. So it's like the husband get double life. What does that mean? So Rashi said that because he is so happy in his life, he's like every day is like he's so thankful and so happy and content that it's like have a double life. As people said, oh, you look so beautiful, you're so so happy and so young and so whatever, that's part of that. העלם אינך מאשת חן, פן תלקד במצודתה. Be careful with a married woman that looks beautiful, because then you reach maybe the יצר הרע, the evil inclination. אל תת אצל בעלה למסוך אמו יין ושחר. Don't go close to her husband to give him wine, to let him get drunk. כי בתואר אישה יפה רבים מושחתו, ועצומים כל הרוגיה, because obviously, we know the consequences. Rabim ayu pitz'e rochel, someone who's selling women perfume, women jewelry, etc. Hamargilim ledvar erva kenitzotz mav'ir gachelet, which is the same way as a little light create a huge fire. You start with a something and then it's reach a big how do you say explosion. Thank you. כחלוב מלא אוף, כן בתיהם מלאים מרמה. So they end up with a lot of untruthful life, meaning life with a lot of adultery. אל תצר צרת מחר, כי לא תדע מה ילד יום. Should not feel sorry for tomorrow, because you don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. שמה מחר בא ואיננו, maybe that person is no longer among the living and the next day he is out there, meaning he is dead, ונמצא מצטער על העולם שאין שלו. So he feels sorry over something that is not his, meaning a person doesn't know if he wake up next day. So if you worry about something that is beyond your control that applies to the future, and you, it may happen that at that time, if anything happened, you will not be around, right? Mena Rabim, that's especially for Dr. Friedman, right? Mena Rabim mitoch beitcha, which is the idea, try to be careful whom you let in your house. Velo akol tavi beitcha. So that's a very famous Gemara that said that a good wife, she always recognized the guests. So sometimes you ask your wife, why you don't want these friends to come in? What's the problem with him? And she tell you, because woman has the bina, has the ability to see things in a deeper way, she said, I don't have a good vibe. I don't want him here. And it turns later on that she's right. רבים יהיו דורשי שלומך. You should have many friends. He's not talking only Twitter or Facebook, right? But גלה סוד לאחד מאלף. But when it's come to tell secrets, don't tell secret to everyone. Be very selective to those whom you share your personal secrets. שולוים מלאכי, שולוים מלאכי.